kill you with your tail tonight.
Oh, puppy. That's what I feel.
Look how good she looks.
It's the first time in more than 5 days that this tiny six-month-old schnauzer has been able to react to her foster mum, Tracey, from rescue group Sydney Animal Second Chance.
So much better.
Little Ellie's been receiving round-the-clock care from the specialists and emergency vet teams in the intensive care section of the Animal Referral Hospital at Homebush.
You know what? She's the best puppy I've ever fostered. She's so beautiful. She loves all dogs, all people.
Well, almost all dogs, definitely not the one that attacked her. We moved out of the busy ICU into a visitor's room to learn precisely what happened to poor little Ellie.
We were on the beach in the middle of nowhere at about 20 past five on Monday, and I had four other dogs with me, and out of nowhere, a large breed dog came towards us, behind us. And the other dogs were pretty disinterested, and for some reason, but I would guess because all dogs are very, Ida loves every single dog.
Yep.
And so she was very enthusiastic to see the dog, and he just landed on top of her. But it was very dark, the moonlight was non-existent, so I just thought he had go of her harness, but she was screaming and the other dogs didn't become involved. Thank goodness, because that would have been even worse. And he had approximately for 5 minutes, and he just dropped her. But, you know, later on during the day, I realised the reason that he dropped her was that he thought she was dead. Because, and then I couldn't find out where the injuries were, because I couldn't see any blood on my hands or anything like that. And I put her on the ground to keep walking, to see what she was like, and she just collapsed. So we're an hour away from the car. I had to carry her back to the car, and we just went straight to our rescue vet at Beverly Hills, and then she came by ambulance here about 2 hours later because she was only saturating at 85% at Dominic's, and so she could not be transferred without being on oxygen.
While the highly experienced emergency vets and nurses swung into action, word of Ellie's plight got out on social media and within hours had gone viral with people all over Australia wanting to help. And now that she's starting to eat a little and eliminate again naturally, there's hope Ellie's broken bones and damaged muscles and organs will continue to heal. And she'll eventually be strong enough to be adopted to a forever home.
Oh, very relieved. Very relieved. I'm so happy I brought her to this wonderful hospital.
For more details on Ellie's progress and how you can help, email sasrescue@gmail.com or go to their page on Facebook, Sydney Animal Second Chance, Inc.